In this teaching tip video, you will learn about learning theory so that you can effectively teach these concepts in your own courses. We will cover 7 different icons of learning theory: Benjamin Bloom, Jerome Bruner, Malcolm Knowles, David Kolb, Jean Piaget, B.F. Skinner, and Edward Thorndike. Let's get started, shall we? To start, let's just say that there is more than just one learning theory. In fact, there are several. But for the sake of time, we will just cover 7 different learning theories, as well as the academics who define them, which we agree will be most beneficial to you. Number 1, Benjamin Bloom. Benjamin Bloom was born in Lansford, Pennsylvania in 1913. He was the author of the learning theory known as Bloom's taxonomy. Bloom's taxonomy is a classification system used to define and distinguish different levels of human cognition, or thinking, learning, and understanding. It is broken up into 6 different levels of learning. These levels are hierarchical, so learning at the higher levels is dependent on having attained prerequisite skills at lower levels. Also, the higher levels are more complex than the lower levels. The awareness and understanding of these levels and where students are in the learning level structure of Bloom's taxonomy can better enable educators to effectively advance their students' learning of the subject. Educators can teach their students based on the assumption that students have already advanced to a certain level of learning within this structure, or not. Number 2. Jerome Bruner. Jerome Bruner was born in New York, New York in 1915. He was the author of the learning theory known as scaffolding. Scaffolding is breaking up the learning into chunks and providing a tool or structure with each chunk. When scaffolding reading, for example, you might preview the text and discuss key vocabulary, or chunk the text and then read and discuss as you go. Number 3. Malcolm Knowles. Malcolm Knowles was born in Livingston, Montana in 1913. He was the author of the learning theory known as andragogy. Andragogy emphasizes that adults are self-directed and expect to take responsibility for decisions. Consequently, adult learning programs must accommodate this fundamental aspect. Andragogy makes the following assumptions about the design of learning. 1. Adults need to know why they need to learn something. 2. Adults need to learn experientially. 3. Adults approach learning as problem solving. And 4. Adults learn best when the topic is of immediate value. In practical terms, andragogy means that instruction for adults needs to focus more on the process and less on the content being taught. Strategies such as case studies, role-playing, simulations, and self-evaluation are most useful. Instructors adopt a role of facilitator or resource rather than lecturer or grader. Number 4. David Kolb. David Kolb was born in Moline, Illinois in 1939. He was the author of the learning theory known as experiential learning. Experiential learning is an engaged learning process whereby students learn by doing and by reflecting on the experience. Experiential learning activities can include, but are not limited to, hands-on laboratory experiments, internships, practicums, field exercises, study abroad, undergraduate research, and studio performances. Learning that is considered experiential contain all of the following elements: reflection, critical analysis, and synthesis. Opportunities for students to take initiative, make decisions, and be accountable for the results. Opportunities for students to engage intellectually, creatively, emotionally, socially, or physically. Number 5. Jean Piaget. Jean Piaget was born in Neuchâtel, Switzerland in 1896. He was the author of the learning theory known as cognitive development. At its very basic level, his theory explains the role that the human brain plays in helping learners understand new and complex concepts. Cognitive processes such as observing, classifying, categorizing, attention, perception, interactivity, and reasoning all play an important role in helping us to learn. What this means is that our ability to effectively absorb, understand, and apply certain concepts and theories is directly related to our cognitive abilities. For example, if a learner lacks a span of attention or can't appropriately observe an instructor conducting a teaching activity, they are less likely to grasp the essence of what's being taught or demonstrated. Number 6. B.F. Skinner. B.F. Skinner was born in Susquehanna, Pennsylvania in 1904. He was the author of the learning theory known as operant conditioning. Through operant conditioning, behavior which is reinforced or rewarded will likely be repeated, and behavior which is punished will occur less frequently. Positive reinforcement is a term described by B.F. Skinner in his theory of operant conditioning. In positive reinforcement, a response or behavior is strengthened by rewards, leading to repetition of desired behavior. For example, if your teacher gives you $20 each time you complete your homework, you will be more likely to repeat this behavior in the future, thus strengthening the behavior of completing your homework. Number 7. Edward Thorndike. Edward Thorndike was born in Williamsburg, Massachusetts in 1874. He was the author of the learning theory known as Law of Effect. Similar to Skinner's theory, Thorndike's theory argues that behaviors that lead to satisfying outcomes are likely to be repeated, whereas behaviors that lead to undesired outcomes are less likely to occur. In this video, we covered 7 different icons of learning theory: Benjamin Bloom, Jerome Bruner, Malcolm Knowles, David Kolb, Jean Piaget, B.F. Skinner, and Edward Thorndike. Now that you know more about 7 different learning theories, you should be better prepared to teach them in your courses. Good luck!